Not even a SWAT team can stop the invasion of a mutant fly on Swamp Thing, 1/2 hour from now. But first, Digby the Talking Dog steps up to bat when Timmy gets benched on Doghouse, next on USA.
Believe it.
He's a bachelor dog in a four-legged cot. Digby the Dog, and woo! He's hot. He's a lovable dog whose bark is worse than his bite, but he's man's best friend, and he'll do you right. Digby's in the doghouse.
Lights. So, to show you how sales are doing, I prepared...
You never know what the day will bring, but the unexpected's a real sure thing.
When your body responds to sudden stress, Sure responds on demand.
Lights.
Sure's on-demand formula helps keep you dry.
Isn't it better to talk face-to-face?
On-demand, you're more sure. Raise your hand.
Sales.
On-demand.
Nice job.
You're more sure.
No little cinnamon gum freshens breath longer than Big Red.
So kiss a little longer, stay close a little longer, hold tight a little longer, longer with Big Red. That Big Red freshness lasts right through it. Your fresh breath goes on and on. While you chew it, say goodbye a little longer, make it last a little longer. Give your breath long-lasting freshness.
Thank goodness my little boy wasn't hurt. But his brand new summer pants were a mess. Grass stains, skinned knees. You're fine. Next morning, blood ruined. I tried Liquid Tide.
With skinned knees, remember, Tide gets out lots of stains, even blood.
All those horrible stains came out. Thanks from a very busy mommy, Donna Valeri.
If it's gotta be clean, it's gotta be Tide.
I think I have the
window
seat over there. If I could just squeeze by here.
We can get out.
Oh, no, that's all right. I don't want to put you up. Sorry, Sergeant.
Aren't you glad you used dial?
Could you hold this for a minute, please? I'll take this off.
Well, folks, a little bit of a traffic jam.
Don't you wish everybody did?
We're number 12 for takeoff.
How Cynthia Bell eats a Reese's peanut butter cup.
I like to eat them in pieces.
Reese's peanut butter cup!
There's no wrong way. Eat a Reese's.
What's he doing? MacGyver, what's he doing with that thing? Weeknights at 7, 6 Central on USA.
Mom, these waffles are unbelievably great. How'd you do it?
Actually, I helped Mom a little with the waffles.
How?
Threw hers out. I made these. Actually, Digby and I made them. He took me through it step by step.
Yeah, and it isn't easy cooking waffles without thumbs.
That's right. I'd forgotten what a talented chef you are. Were. Are.
Uncle Digby, a chef? I thought the only thing you could make were lawn patties.
Before I considered bugs a delicacy, I could fricassee a chicken with my eyes closed.
Must have made for a very messy kitchen.
Hey, even Picasso spilled a little paint.
I'll get it. Hello? Oh, hi, Mrs. Fox. What? His appendix burst. No. Tell Freddy not to worry about the game. I just hope he's going to be okay. Yeah. Thanks for calling. Bye-bye. Can you believe this? Freddy Fox's appendix burst this morning. His mom says he can't play in the big game tomorrow. Is she being overprotective or what?
That's mothers for you. Just a bunch of wussies. She won't let her kid play just because he's got more stitches in his stomach than in his glove.
Richie, you're in big trouble. Half the team out with the flu, Freddy out with his appendix.
Actually, the appendix is out of Freddy.
What are you gonna do?
Timmy, my boy, it's not what I'm going to do. It's what you are going to do.
No, really? You're gonna put me in the game? Wait a minute. You can't put me in the game.
Why not? You've been asking to play all season.
But this is a playoff game. It's important.
Timmy, don't just do it for me. Do it for your older brother. Someone who has always been there for you. Do it for the team, the Glickman Blue Jays, who, I might remind you, is sponsored by Mom's boss.
Good guilt, Rich. You'd make a great mother.
Please don't make me do this.
Timmy, relax. You've got nothing to worry about. You've made good contact with the ball lately.
Just went hit my helmet.
Honey, it's only a game. And you'll be great. Just think you could be the next Wayne Gretzky.
Wrong sport, Helen.
The point is, unless you get out there and try, you'll never accomplish anything.
Well...
Come on, Timmy. Don't act like an underdog. Act like an Underwood. Clever, huh?
Well, okay. Maybe you're right. Okay, I'll do it.
Hey, Timmy! Lugger. You look terrific!
I've got a good feeling about this.
Hiya, sports fans.
So much for good feelings.
Guess who's doing the play-by-play for the Clearview baseball playoffs? The one, the only...
Oh, please let it be Vin Scully.
Ted Shepard.
Does Lauren Glickman know you are doing the play-by-play?
Know it. He wants the very best announcer for his Blue Jays that money can buy. Cost me $50, but I think the exposure is going to be worth it.
No offense or anything, Ted, but what do you know about baseball?
It's the nation's pastime, okay? 9 guys on the field, chewing, spitting, and scratching, you know.
Spit and scratch. Sounds like a Bulgarian lotto game.
Besides, the regular announcer's home in bed with laryngitis. Personally, I've never been attracted to Greek women.
The man's a card-carrying idiot.
Well, gotta split. Laura wants me to learn my stats. Those are those things that you put on your shoes, aren't they?
I believe you're thinking of spats, Ted.
I knew that. Well, see you at the ballpark, guys.
Bye, Ted.
One thing for sure, I won't do any worse playing the game, and Ted will do announcing it.
Ladies and gentlemen, you couldn't ask for anything more. It's a real barn burner. It's the bottom of the ninth, nobody out, and the Glickman Blue Jays are clinging to a 2-0 lead over the Red Sox.
Please don't hit it to me. Oh, please don't hit it to me. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Way to go, guys! Way to go! Come on, let's go! 2 more out! We go to the championship!
All right, Timmy! You're doing great! Go get him, Slugger!
Helen, I didn't know you encouraged your children to be violent.
Oh, no, Iris. Slugger is an affectionate term for a good batter.
Well, I make a fine batter, but I never thought to name it. You see, what I do is I put in a little bit of extra yeast, and then I substitute margarine for butter.
Ladies and gentlemen, it has been some game. But while we have this little break in the action,
I'd like to take this time to say thank you to the man that makes this all possible. To a man I like to call Lorne. But he won't let me. Ladies and gentlemen, won't you please give it up for Mr. Lorne Glickman?
Thanks, Teddy, old boy. You're my main man.
All right, I see we're ready to get back to the game now. Let's go, Bluebirds!
Blue Jays! This guy couldn't get any dumber if you cut off his head. And now, up to bat. Little snubby Bance.
This is great.
No, go away. Don't come out here. A big mistake.
Well, what happened?
Remember that new glove you bought Timmy?
Yes.
Well, it's still new.
And stepping up to the plate is Mitchell Randy Cohen. What's he doing? He appears to be pointing directly at Timmy Underwood.
Who does he think he is? Babe Ruth?
No, thanks, dear. The caramel gets stuck in the dentures.
Come on, nerdball. Make my day.
I was bluffing. I meant some other day.
Safe!
Oh, my ankle.
Oh, my gosh. Timmy's hurt. He's holding his leg.
Leave him alone. It's the only thing he's had in his glove all game. The kid couldn't catch flies off a no-pest strip.
Well, Mitchell Randy is on with a double after a beautiful slide. And speaking of sliding, remember, Glickman & Glickman Hillside Properties can be financed with easy monthly payments of practically anything.
How's it feel, Timmy?
I'm okay. Rolly, it's nothing.
Honey, I think you better sit this one out.
No, I'm okay. Just let me back in the game. I'm ready. Let me at him. Ow!
No, I can't let you play on this ankle.
Oh, shucks.
Richie, looks like you're going to have to forfeit the game. Your bench is empty. You only got 8 players on the field. Rule book says you got to have 9.
Forfeit? Not the F word.
Well, a black day here for the Blue Jays, folks. A lot of sad little boys will be sitting around their dinner tables tonight, but none of them will be as sad as little Timmy Underwood. He tried, but just didn't have it. So long, everybody. This is Ted Shepard signing off. And remember, because it's such a bummer of a day, my autograph today will be half price. Thank you.
Anyway. Ankh, what are you doing? Digby, I don't have time to play frisbee.
I've got a plan. Put me in the game.
That's your plan? The fur must have started growing inside your head.
Come on, Rich, I was the star of my high school baseball team.
You had 2 legs in high school.
Richie, if the Blue Jays lose on a technicality, everyone's gonna blame it on Timmy. You gotta put me in.
Everybody in! Game over!
Wait a minute. We got another player.
Sorry, Richie, you're too old.
Not me. Him.
This is a joke, right?
No joke. Where in the book does it say a dog can't play?
What? Are you crazy? No mangy mutt's going to wear a Glickman & Glickman uniform.
Okay, I gotta concentrate. Watch the ball, don't sniff the grass. Watch the ball, don't sniff the grass.
Thanks, Manuel. Now playing right field for the Blue Jays, Digby Underwood. Digby is a southpaw and a northpaw, and an eastpaw and a westpaw. Holy cow!
Play ball! The score is 2-1 for the Glickman Blue Jays with 1 out!
to make the record book as the only player to be benched for a dog.
Honey, that's ridiculous.
Besides, you should be celebrating. Your team won.
Do I look like I'm part of the team?
Hey, Mom. What are you making?
Timmy's favorite, SpaghettiOs.
Poor kid. You know, he really had a rough day. He tried so hard.
Not hard enough. Hey, I'm his older sister. I'm supposed to be obnoxious.
But Uncle Digby showed him who was king, didn't
you? Yeah.
Here, king. Here, king.
Hey, how about a little respect for the team hero?
Respect? Uncle Digby, I worship you. You saved the team from total humiliation today.
Yeah, three cheers for Digby. Hip hip hooray!
Hooray! Hip hip hooray! Hooray! Hip hip hooray!
You'll never even know I'm gone.
You did great, buddy. Number one, man, I can believe.
Take chances. You turn to the medicine you count on, Children's Tylenol. You've proven it works for him ever since he was a baby. And when he's sick, he's still your baby. Children's Tylenol, the one most pediatricians give their own children.
I feel better, Mommy.
And for sneezing, aches, and congestion, try Children's Tylenol cold.
Exciting Jeeps. Luxurious Eagles. Verona Jeep Eagle. Now, thanks to Verona Jeep Eagle's Nobody Sells for Less policy, traveling in style is affordable. For over 30 years, customers have come to depend on family-owned Verona Jeep Eagle, where the price brings you in and the service brings you back, whether it's a new Jeep, a new Eagle, or a used car. Buy for less at Verona Jeep Eagle, with two convenient locations, Allegheny River Boulevard and Verona Road, Penn Hills.
Whoever thought this would happen? An English teacher from West Virginia teaching in Budapest. I'm part of the first Peace Corps team in Eastern Europe. It's an amazing time to be here. I'm learning Hungarians are a lot like we are. They love their freedom, and they're open to new ideas.
And the government of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth.
There's a lot of work ahead of us, but I can't think of any job I'd rather have.
Peace Corps, the toughest job you'll ever love.
Jolly good kid, which nobody can deny.
All right, dinner is ready. Why don't you run up and get your brother?
Digby, remember, you're in training. No ice cream.
No ice cream, no smoking, no drinking, no women. I should just change my name to Pope John Digby.
Here, Digby. Lap it up. I'll tell Richie I ate it.
Thanks, Annie. I won't lick your retainer anymore when it's sitting on the nightstand.
Ew!
He's gone.
What do you mean, he's gone?
First he's here, now he's not.
Maybe he's hiding in the hamper again. You know how he hates to part with his socks.
I don't think he's hiding.
Why not? Dear Mom, just in case you're interested, I've run away. Goodbye, Timmy. Well, I'm calling the police.
Wait a minute. I am the police. I was the police. I know police. Look, we can find him ourselves. I'm a St. Bernard. Finding people is in my genes. Besides, cops are still looking for Jimmy Hoffa.
I had no idea he was so upset.
What are we gonna do? We can't just stand around here all night.
Okay, let's spread out. Richie, you knock on doors.
Right.
Annabelle, you check the video arcade.
Okay.
Helen, you and I'll cruise the neighborhood.
You drive, okay? It's my turn to stick my head out the window. Some St. Bernard I am. I can't even find my own nephew. Maybe we should have called the cops. I hope Richie and Annabelle have more luck than we did. Wait a minute. Somebody's in my doghouse. Maybe that sexy little poodle has taken me up on my offer and come for a midnight rendezvous. It's only 7 o'clock, but who said poodles were bright? Come out, Pee-Pee. I'll put another pom-pom in your tail. Timmy, what are you doing in the flea motel?
In case you didn't notice, I ran away.
You didn't get very far.
I didn't know where to go.
Why didn't you just come home? Everybody's very worried about you, you know. Especially your mom.
She's not worried. She doesn't even care. Nobody cares.
That's silly. We all care about you.
Oh, yeah? I heard Richie, Annabelle, and Mom say how much they worship you. You were the team hero. Well, if they love you so much, you can be their son, and I'll be the family dog.
Timmy, I'd let you have the job, but I'm afraid you're short two legs and a tail. But you know what? Maybe running away is a good idea.
You think so?
Sure. You said yourself your family doesn't care. They won't miss you.
Well, I...
Face it, Tim. Your mother's always bothering you, telling you to wash behind your ears, kissing you goodnight when she thinks you're asleep, putting an extra cookie in your lunchbox. Little things like that can be a drag on a guy.
Yeah, but...
It's such a great idea. I'm going with you.
You are?
Sure, it'll be great. Just you and me sleeping outdoors under the stars, in the cold, in the rain, in the mud with the bugs. We'll get our food out of dumpsters. Know something? I'm getting excited about this.
Bugs and mud, huh? Sounds great.
Thought I heard talking out here. Honey, are you all right? I've been worried sick about you.
Really?
Of course.
Mom, suppose a kid runs away and then decides he doesn't want to run away anymore. Is it all right for him to change his mind?
If I remember correctly, the runaway rule book says a kid can change his mind and come home anytime he likes.
Great. Can we go inside now?
Sure. Your SpaghettiOs are getting cold.
You made me SpaghettiOs?
Your mom must really love you to make your favorite meal.
Yeah, I guess she really does.
Thanks, Dix.
Hey, no problemo, Helen.
Championship game, top of the ninth, two out, and the go-ahead run is coming to the plate. Oh, the tension's so thick you can cut it with a bing. Who's coming after the plate? It's Doogie McIntyre. What a geek!
First, go get him, buddy. Go.
Digby, you're limping. What happened?
I think I just tore my rotator cuff, whatever the heck that is.
Gonna be all right? No, I need your speed and your 3-inch strike zone and your do up next.
I don't know. I got an awful bum paw.
I thought it was your rotator cuff.
Same thing. On a dog, it's all connected.
Yeah, Stevie!
Wait a minute. This is not great. I got a man on first, man on third, and no batter.
Timmy, why don't you pinch hit? Your ankle's better.
Digby, I think you hurt your head, not your leg. I'm terrible, remember?
Timmy, all you gotta do is go out there and do your best. That is, if you want to. It's your decision.
All right, give me that bat before I change my mind.
Yeah, go get him, Timmy, come on!
All right! The winning runs on third, and who's coming up to bat?
Oh, look, it's Timmy.
Oh, no! It's clumsy Timmy Underwood!
You can choke up on your bat, move into the ball. I can do it. I can do it.
Why aren't you limping?
I am.
Wrong paw, Digby. Come on, Timmy, let's go, buddy!
Skin with ivory. Ivory's mild, gentle, 99.44% pure.
You're my ivory, baby.
Now save on Rodgers and Hammerstein musicals when you buy either ivory product. Details at participating stores.
This man is a dentist, so we can't show you his face on television. Warning, Rob. But the fact that he's brushing his teeth may prompt you to ask, what brand of toothbrush do dentists use? Okay, Rob, show us. Oral B. Used by more dentists than any other brand of toothbrush. Oral B. The toothbrush more dentists use.
When you should be home, but you can't be home. New Formula 44M. The only one for coughs that relieves congestion, runny nose, and headache. It's the multi-symptom cough and cold medicine.
Couldn't miss our last class. I had to be sure 20 people I am very proud of become citizens of this country.
When you should be home, but you can't be home. New Vicks Formula 44M.
Richie's got a bad case of puppy love.
My heart rate's already up.
Helen wants to curb his animal instincts.
That's what parents do.
Whoa. Doghouse on USA. An all-new episode next Sunday at 4:30.
A deadly venom threatens a boy's life.
I'm here, Jim.
Swamp Thing on USA. Coming up next. There's a shakeup in the locker room. A rumble on the field. Don't miss the kickoff. World League Football. Coming this spring on USA.
The laughs keep on multiplying with just the 10 of us. Weekdays at 5. 1/2 hour from now, two desperate travelers trust their lives to the kindness of strangers on Alfred Hitchcock Presents. But first, could its buzz be worse than its bite? A deadly mutant fly invades on Swamp Thing, next on USA.
USA, America's favorite cable network.